Welcome back to another Uncle Roger's video. Last week we don't have a video, so today there's a video called Jamie Oliver finally impressed Uncle Roger? Question mark. It's not exclamation mark, it's question mark. So there must be something into it, right? But maybe it's not that bad. So yeah, let's watch it. Let's see. Probably this time it's an Italian dish, like he mentioned in the last video. He says he's gonna review one of the Italian dishes that Jamie Oliver did, right? So let's not wait, let's watch.
Last time, Jamie Oliver messed up Thai green curry so bad, he made all our ancestors cry. Hiya. Now he back with new TV show and he making Thai green curry again.
Oh,
how he gonna do? Niece and nephew,
again?
This
okay.
is Uncle Roger, new studio. Work in progress. I got all my favorite thing here. Rice cooker, pestle mortar, and lucky cat. But here's still empty. Uncle Roger thinking of putting neon sign here. What should neon sign say? Should it say MSG? Or should it be picture of rice cooker? Leave comment. Let Uncle Roger know what you want the neon sign here to say.
We're back on the pier.
Our lovely old cafe is open for business.
Oh, it's the same place again, okay. I'm so sorry. He needs a partner to open up another one. Okay.
Why he always cooking in weird place? He make ramen outside truck. Last time he make green curry in antique kitchen. This Jamie never cook anywhere normal. Jamie, you got problem at home.
One
is
day
it? Trying to escape your wife?
Underwater.
I think Jamie Oliver always telling his wife, honey, dinner ready in 5 minutes. Let me just quickly pop to ocean.
I love Thai food.
This Greg Davis, famous comedian in UK.
Green curries, I could just exist on green curry.
Yeah.
Green curries. The little tiny places sometimes, as well as the big restaurants.
I mean, I look like I...
Uncle Roger don't know who the other guy is. Nobody give a shit.
What I love is that you loved it so much, even though you got bitten by mozzies.
Bitten by Mossy.
And you've bought a load of mozzies into...
Well, I've got 30,000 mozzies and a Thai green curry to teach you.
What is Mossy?
Teach you, okay.
Mossy is British slang for mosquito. That's so weird. Just say mosquito. Why you give mosquito cute nickname like Mossy?
Bought a load of mozzies into...
Well, I've got 30,000 mozzies and a Thai green curry to teach you.
What?
And a Thai green curry to teach you.
Jamie Oliver gonna be your teacher for Thai green curry. Oh no, you know how bad he fucked it up last time? That like getting BBC food to teach you how to make egg fried rice, hiya.
I'm excited.
The thing is, right, you see a Thai green curry. So I think he mistaken by the green is like vegetables, maybe. So yeah, there you go.
Decided to go and find the best chef in Thailand. This is Chef McDang.
Oh, he using a Thai chef recipe. Okay.
One part to another.
Maybe this will be good.
The base of any good curry is the paste.
Give me your hand, lovely dear chap. Well, not to shake, but as a vehicle. 2 teaspoons of cumin.
Okay.
2 teaspoons of coriander seed.
Good. Cumin, coriander, good.
Put those in the wok over there.
What he say?
You're gonna put those in the wok over there.
Jamie have wok. Oh my god, this is my first time seeing Jamie with wok for you.
Hey.
Jamie, you finally can afford wok now. Welcome to the club.
Those to bring them back to life.
Oh wait.
When this
toast correctures
now,
okay.
Pop to them. Then you can start to
pestle and mortar. Oh, correct again. Jamie, 2 out of 2 so far.
Not bad.
Are you good at banging?
You know, are you?
Wait, actually, why don't he just the things first before you throw it in? It is supposed to do that first. I don't know.
Used to be a bit sluggish these days.
Same as Uncle Roger. I getting old now. Bang halfway, I need to take break. Catch my breath.
Next, we're gonna pound 2 to 4 de-seeded green chilies and 12 small whole chilies.
I actually haven't got the energy to take the seeds out of these ones.
Oh? He actually not de-seeding them this time.
You only have to do this like once or twice a year. You can make a batch and freeze it. And then when you come back from a gig, a few prawns.
You think I'm gonna do this when I get home?
I hope so.
They not.
never going to happen, is it?
These two people, multi-millionaire, they're not going to pound themselves. They're going to hire some Thai children to pound for them. Oh, like, remember that Thai football team that got stuck in that cave? Now they're stuck in Jamie Oliver's basement.
Four lemongrass. And for that, we're going to give it...
Like, he never see lemongrass before.
To break down the fibres.
OK.
So...
Why
stop spanking. You're going to pound it later in pestle and mortar anyway. Spank for what? It's Jamie becoming like Nephew Nick, spanking everything.
Add the zest of two kaffir limes.
Correct.
Okay. Chop galangal.
Galangal?
Got it. 8 cloves of garlic and pop in 10 peeled Thai shallots.
Shallot. Very nice.
And smash them. Smash
yo, Jamie, getting all the ingredients right this time. Uncle Roger feels so happy. No mushroom and munch too this time.
Yes.
Good. He learning. I think Jamie watch Uncle Roger video and learn the proper way.
Yeah, maybe.
Not McDang.
Yeah. Maybe,
a lot
maybe.
Of love goes into
maybe.
It.
Maybe.
Now, something you might not like. Shrimp paste.
Oh, I don't like it.
Really?
That is disgusting. Do you know what that reminds me of? Cleaning my guinea pigs out when I was a kid.
What?
Well, it looks quite
that
similar.
No, that definitely smells different.
That is the whitest conversation about shrimp paste Uncle Roger ever hear. Shrimp paste is one of the most delicious food you compare.
I think like shrimp paste is kind of sweet at the same. It actually tastes sweet, right? Only the smell maybe a bit, you know, but still, I don't think it tastes weird.
To guinea pig. Why white people like all these weird pet? Don't keep guinea pig as pet. Use for experiment only.
For experiment as well.
White pepper.
Nice, correct.
So we're going to give it just a little bit of love.
I'm just nervous about shrimp getting that shrimp paste.
Shall I get a penny for you?
Yeah, let's have a penny.
Yeah.
A what? Penny?
Precious about this.
What is
shirt?
Oh, penny mean apron. Why so weird these British people?
Oh,
first you call
so
mosquito
cute.
Mossy, then you call apron penny. What? You invent English language, but you also fuck it up.
So now we're going.
This is why you have problems learning English. I get your English right. Stop using cute name.
And back in with the spices.
The cumin and coriander.
I think you've done a great job. That is.
Wait.
A beautiful paste.
Wait,
as you can smell, it's...
No, it not paste. You haven't finished pounding.
Yeah.
Paste not supposed to look like fiber. Don't
it's
pour
like,
out. Put
it has like vegetables on blender.
Back in pestle and mortar, you haven't finished pounding. Hiya. Look at Mark Winwicho. Look at how the green curry paste supposed to look when you finish pounding. It not supposed to look like ball of
I think
hay,
blender
pounding
looks better, right?
Green curry paste take longer than this. I feel bad for both their wife. They finished too early. I'm not sorry, I'm dirty.
Nice.
Children.
I'm not sorry, I'm dirty.
Quite pungent, and a little goes a long way. I am gonna leave you now.
No, don't leave him.
Just done.
Oh. Don't leave him. He not actual chef, but I guess neither is Jamie Oliver.
So this is the good bit. You've done the pounding, now it's the making.
Let's cook.
We have a wok.
Yeah.
It's on a medium
wok. Good.
Just
high
a small
heat.
Wok. Small
we're gonna put some vegetable oil in.
Vegetable oil? No.
Why so
green
weak?
Curry. You start by cooking the coconut milk, heat it up until the fat separate from it.
I'm gonna go in
true.
With 3 heaped tablespoons of your beautiful paste. Congratulations, you did
Thank
a great
you very
job.
Much.
So one.
Not beautiful.
Two. And 3.
So, but you, now you're just stir-frying the paste?
Yeah, why don't?
Put just a tablespoon or 2 of...
Okay, now you put the coconut cream in there.
It just clags it up a bit, and you can kind of push it around the pan a little bit more, and it makes it easier to sort of toast up.
The rest of the coconut cream goes in.
Okay, wait, what? Oh, my God. Why don't you just put all the coconut cream in beginning?
Yeah.
That's what you're supposed to do. Why you put 2 spoons first?
The cameraman is supposed to put all of it in, right? Then he's like, oh, yeah, the recipe said that. I don't know.
Then put the whole pot. Why?
Simmering, we'll add 600 grams of free-range chicken thighs.
Okay.
Thighs have got much better flavour.
Correct.
Tender and delicious. So we'll mix that up. And then we go in with 3 tins of coconut milk.
What? Oh. How much coconut you want to put in
Why
there?
Why do you put so
you
many?
Just put 2 can of coconut cream. Now you adding another can of coconut milk. That's
it's
too
gonna
much.
Be white instead
Uncle Roger
of green.
Predict your curry not even gonna look green.
Yeah, no, it's gonna be white.
You know, 8 portions.
Thai green curry version 2. I will call it carbonara version 2. It's gonna be look like carbonara again, right? Without the magnitude and like mushroom and shit.
Okay.
Is it?
Yeah. Add 4 or 5 kaffir lime leaves.
See? See how white the curry is? It whiter than both of them combined. This green curry is so white, it about to teach yoga class.
Will give the most incredible flavour. So, yeah. Rice, how are you at cooking it?
Oh, mine's always a stodgy mess.
Uh-oh. Jamie cooking rice. Uncle Roger don't have good feeling about this.
Rice pack again.
So, for perfect rice, 1 cup of rice to 2 cups of water. Pinch of salt, boil it hard, and by the time 12...
No, you don't start with boiling water.
Bingo bango every single time.
Oh, what is bingo bango?
Okay, so I'm not sure about using hot water first, but does it mean that it's gonna make a... make the water... like evaporate more faster than usual, then it's gonna make the rice be less cooked? Is that how science work? Because I've never seen anybody use hot water to make rice. I've never seen anybody do that. Does your house do that? That's weird. I'm not gonna lie, that's weird.
Is it Latin for shit at cooking rice?
Repeat exactly what we've done.
I am categorically not okay to do it. Okay, I'll give it a go.
Good luck, my friend.
Thank you.
What is it?
Jamie leaving again, like how my wife Auntie Helen did.
And Greg's about to get his hands on his Thai green chicken curry.
We are at-
so. Why is he leaving him? Like the things are not done, right? Is he leaving for like a certain reason, or he's gonna look at the recipe or something? You're leaving a unprofessional. Chef, no, I mean like he's not even chef in the kitchen. So
at that
too white
place, we are nearly ready to serve.
I mean, it's a miracle I haven't eaten it already.
Have a little taste.
Oh my life!
I mean, it's got so much going on there, isn't it?
I mean, it mainly coconut milk going on.
Yes. I'm amazed it needs anything else. It's delicious.
McDan says
really
3 tablespoons to 4
oh!
fish sauce. Look, in my experience, fish sauce
squid. Squid brand fish sauce for you! Okay, okay, Uncle Roger, get some respect for Jamie Oliver now.
So let's
and that's so full of flavour already.
Let's do 2.5. Let's have another little taste.
How is it greener now?
Oh, it's getting better. Oh,
of course, it's getting better.
Let's go to the 3.
Fish sauce, just like MSG, it makes everything better. If MSG king of flavour, then fish sauce
queen.
Is queen of flavour. Just squirt it everywhere. Just squirt.
Add 2 teaspoons of organic palm sugar.
Ah.
5
nice
Thai aubergines quartered.
Thai eggplant, not bad. Jamie Oliver getting it right again.
And pop them in towards the end of cooking to keep their crunch.
Correct.
Along with a couple of sprigs of Thai basil.
Correct again.
Tear some of those in, but you don't want the stalk.
And a final hit of heat from 2 more sliced chilies.
Chili. Oh my god. Jamie doing chili right this time. Remember in his previous Thai green curry, Jamie used 3 chili only. 3?
I'm gonna go.
I don't know. 3. Wait, okay. So in the beginning of the video, I don't see how many chili he used. I only saw he like seed out the 2 or 3 chilies. So even just now he added the red chili in. It doesn't look a lot. So I don't know how much the quantity actually he used. So maybe if you guys know, you can tell me.
But now he used so many.
2 to 4 deseeded green chilies, 12 small whole chilies, 2 more sliced chilies.
There you go.
I think Jamie Oliver, not pussy anymore. He can handle spice now.
Pretty much ready and raring to go. Your rice has had.
Oh, rice.
So off it comes.
And look at that.
Perfect fluffy rice.
Not sticky, he's right.
Too wet. See here, look a bit wet. Jamie, just one time, Jamie. Just get rice cooker. Hit Uncle Roger up. I send you rice cooker for free. I want to see you use rice cooker in your cooking show.
How is that
perfect,
so wet?
Fluffy rice.
It's not sticky, he's right.
And also, metal spoon in non-stick saucepan.
Come on, then.
No.
That's a big old portion, isn't it?
Come over here, mate.
Oh, my.
And have a little go on that.
I thought that bowl was like a rice cooker. I mean a rice cooker bowl thing, and they just directly put the Thai green curry inside. I was like, never mind.
No need to put coriander on there.
Dan knows what he's talking about. There's so many flavors in it, and the chili comes through in a really lovely way.
So does this transport you back to Thailand?
No. Yeah?
What? Why Jamie holding spoon so awkward? He holding spoon like.
I was being ravaged by mosquitoes.
Oh, we could arrange that.
This green curry, all ingredient correct? Fuyo! Just cooking step a few thing wrong. Uncle Roger think the Thai chef told Jamie what ingredient to use, but didn't tell him what order to put it in. But
oh,
Jamie,
yeah.
This still much better than your previous green curry
okay,
we
la,
just
but
did.
Still, most of the chef that they do, right, that recipe, they must be step by step. I don't think they just put in this is all you need to make and that's it. I don't think that's how they make the recipe for people. So, I just think that Jamie Oliver did not read everything. That's what I can say.
It baby step, you're gonna make perfect Thai green curry. Maybe in 25 year time.
In our South End cafe, we're cooking up a feast that you'll want to get involved in this weekend.
Jamie Oliver's cooking for you. It's madness.
Correct. That madness. If Jamie Oliver cooked for me, Uncle Roger mad also. It's not supposed to look like coleslaw. Yeah, your shrimp paste look like salad.
Yeah, kind of like little salad.
Uncle Roger banging very sluggish also. Bang halfway, need to take break. Need to take my heart medication. Cannot handle. My heart cannot handle long banging session. Every night, Uncle Roger put energy drink by my bedside table. If I know I'm gonna bang, what am I saying? Anyways,
yeah, he's trying so hard for
maybe
a dirty
they
joke.
Hired the Thai football team who stuck in cave. Now they stuck in Jamie Oliver house.
I think I'm getting delirious from the tiredness.
This green curry is so white. It about to start a podcast.
Quick update, nieces and nephews. I've been so stressed these days with the moving and I have other projects I'm working on. And I'm also going on tour soon for stand-up. So I've just been really, really busy. But making these videos for you guys always brings me joy. Thank you for watching.
Okay, that's it for this video. Hope you guys enjoy my reactions. And definitely did not have a lot of shocking things. I also do not have a lot of complaints, but still some of the steps are just kind of sus, you know, like questionable things. There's still, yeah, questionable things. I mean, it's Jamie Oliver, you can't expect much from him, but like you're following someone's recipe and you still can mess up though. I don't think it's a mess up lah. It's still okay. It still tastes like Thai green curry, I hope, but it's definitely way too white. So I don't think that's impressive, right? I don't know, man. I'm gonna just say it's impressed, so I'll just take it, I guess. And hope you subscribe to my channel. I'm hitting 1,000 subscribers in YouTube. Hope I hit it soon. I'm at 600 right now, so hope you guys can drop a follow blah, drop a subscription, subscribe, whatever, right? It's free. And check me out as well on Twitch. I play Valorant, I play New World recently a lot, totally not addicted. And yeah, thank you for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.